For for Sister Ruffin, Lord, for these many years.
Oh, yes.
Father, she have been through some storms in her life. Oh, dear Lord, but you watched over her and kept her, Lord, from falling, dear Master.
Yes.
And we just want to thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Father, we believe and we trust in that you're going to roll many, many years onto her life. Father, help her each day of her life. Father, because she's living and dependent on you.
Oh, yes.
Father, man has fallen by the wayside. Father, we will lift you up. Father, you will do all the glory. Father, we thank you, dear Master, for those that will pass this food. Father, please, sir, let it be a nourishment to our bodies. Bless every home. Bless those that have drove far and drove near.
Oh, yes.
Bless us, oh, dear Master, as we depart from this place when it's all over. But please, sir, dear Master, don't depart from our presence. In Jesus' name we pray and give all the glory.
Amen.
Amen.
We're going to do this in chronological order, so I'm going to ask my oldest sister.
First, I want to introduce my husband in his absence. He had to be at work, and he said, tell you happy birthday, I'm sorry he couldn't be with you. And my oldest son and his wife are here. I think she's gone now for a few minutes. Brother Lloyd Davis Jr., Brother Willie Davis, my second son, Kenny Davis and his wife,
Shreveport home, the Wiley home.
sort of place it was for the five of us. Three girls, two boys. You taught us from birth till now. Love, obedient. Mother, there were times we were disobedient. Mother, we thank you. We thank you. We thank you for being there when we were wrong. One thing, Mother, we can always say, you were there. Thank you, Mother. Mother, we thank you for your spiritual mind. Taught us to, taking us to Sunday school. Taught us to pray. And the first prayer that you taught us, now lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. That was the first prayer that our mother taught us. I can always remember that prayer. First prayer. Okay, Mother, I said that already. You read the Bible to us. You taught us to forgive each other. Mother, forgive us. Mother, for failing to see the small opportunity you gave us to pass on your love. You reminded us that we are all part of your family. Mother, I could talk on and on and on. To sum all this up, Mother, the words of Proverbs 3:31 are being fulfilled. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above riches. Verse 10. Stones of life, Mother. We do not always weather the stones of life easily. Sometimes we face great difficulties. Hungry, homeless, such abuse, sickness, and sorrows, difficult. We cannot understand, but the same God who parted the Red Sea for the Israelites will part the waters of adversities for us. Helping us, Mother, we thank you for helping us through the difficult times. God walks beside us, supporting us with love and compassion. Thank you, Mother, and thank you, Grandmother.
Monroe, Iverson, Ruffin. Okay? That's where it all started. All right.
church. Okay? That's the first thing we must do in our lives. Because we cannot go, we cannot survive, we cannot live in this world without God. Okay? My nieces and my great nieces, my grandnieces, all of you all. And another thing I want you all to do, y'all must be obedient. You've got to be obedient to your parents. You've got to be obedient to your teacher. And you got to be obedient to God. First, you got to be obedient to God. Mama got a lot of grandkids, and they all are not here. Like we get to adding up, we got probably over 100. That's something, you know. Because I must say, Mama, she taught us, okay? There was time when we had to walk the railroad tracks. We had to hide back then, them days back then, you know? Your kids got it good. See, when we was coming up, we didn't know anything about integration, okay? So this is what we can't, that's why we can't forget our parents, our grandmother, our great-grandmother and things. Because they opened the way for us. First, God did, okay? This is what I want you to understand. Y'all always remember that. Remember Grandma. And remember Big Mama. Mama and Jack and Manel and Theo and Sonny Boy and Mary. Y'all remember all of that. That's love, okay? She taught us to love one another. But first, I must say I'm very happy. I'm just happy because this has been a hard struggle. I done called Mom and I done lied to her on the telephone. Told her gifts would be in the mail today, you know. But it all was for happiness, you know. But first, I want to introduce my friend. I have one daughter, Diane. Her husband, Reverend Baker. Okay, now I got one granddaughter, Tanya Renee Johnson. Her husband, Malcolm Johnson. Bryce Knight. And Taylor Johnson. This is my family, very small. And my husband.
Very happy for today. That, really enjoy. I'm gonna call my wife up. This is just the
daughter, Andy. been a good mother to me, and I know a lot of times coming up, I gave her natural. But she kept on loving me. She kept on pointing me in the right direction. And I look back on those days now, and the things that she was telling me then, I didn't realize. But now I see a lot of them. That she told me things that would happen, you know. And I can say to the young people here, listen to your mother. Listen to your parents. And one thing stand out in my mind, she always told me, God don't like us. She always tell me, God don't like us. And I think about that to this day. And I want to say to her, mother, I love you. You've been an inspiration in my life. I'm cool. But before I sit down, I'm going to ask my wife to sing the Lord's Prayer.
Amen.
And dedicate it to you.
Amen. Let's do the tribute.
Yes.
Okay, let's
before become. Y'all do all that, I just want to say one thing.
Okay. Sins and griefs
temporary, but part-time. She wants to come. She's had some hard times. She's had some hills to climb. But she won't complain. And through it all, through the hard times, through raising you guys, through, I'm sure, a lot of times she's gone without meals. There are a lot of times she probably went without shoes. She went without a lot just to get you guys to where you are now. I like to say she is a blessing. I hope you little guys, you know, you don't realize what they've gone through. And I hope y'all really, really stop and think about what you've got here. You've got history sitting here. You've got blessings sitting here. Take advantage of her. Take advantage of the knowledge. Take advantage of her experience. Find out what has gone past through her. Because she's a lot. You guys have really, really, really got a blessing here. She's had some hard times. She's had some rough times. But through it all, she's made it.
Very nice what you're doing. I think it's really nice and the children that thank them right there the most. Many of you won't even think this. And I think it's very nice and the children that thank the mother like you're doing. I enjoy everything.
Something wrong somewhere. And this, y'all know how I feel. Because
serving the mess. And I keep the smile on my face. Sometimes when I was raising my children and going to my job, my heart would be bleeding, but I'd have a smile. And everybody said, oh, you're just smiling this morning. I said, oh, yeah, glad to be here. Because God don't have to let us be here. Because I got a testimony, I can tell it till I die.
Amen.
What he brought me through this past year, last year. I'm telling you, he showed me things. Brought me on, and I never did get afraid. And I'm telling you, when you close to him, and live in time and love, don't care how other people talk and hate, you love. Because see, he got the book of life up there. And ain't no use of fooling ourselves. But I did all I could for my children. Sometimes you just had a little bread, a little piece of it, but we had that love. Kept that love. And going to church, I put them in all that all in. Get out in front of them, and I would whip. I didn't say I'm good, I would whip.
Right,
you know?
Right.
And now a lot of young mothers send the church. They don't go with them. You go with them to church and let them know about God. Sometimes they may stray away. They'll do that, but they'll come back. Because that's the way my mother raised me. Every Sunday morning in Sunday school, she sent me. I mean, she did. And it made a woman out of me. I ain't been perfect, anybody perfect, though. But you grow in grace.
That's
to be
right.
Strong, you know? Yeah, you got to love. That's the only thing. Just love everybody. If whatever going, love. And I guarantee you, you'll take care of it. I learned that. The hard. And I just love everybody. There are a lot of people that, I don't see how you, I said, that don't bother me. I love it. It don't bother me. Because God made me. He made me what I am. Jesus. And I stood by him. Put my finger in his face now. I stood by him when he got down like he did. I prayed.
Yeah.
God enabled him to make another step.
Yeah.
Now think about that. Pray. It's a blessing. Then he put me back on my feet to still. Yeah. You know? Nobody but God. Nobody else ain't gonna do that. Nobody but God. That's all. And stay with him, y'all. You know, ain't nobody perfect but God. But stay with my Lord Jesus Christ. And prayer, that's the kingdom. Keep on praying. And y'all don't know how you made me feel tonight. I'm just so happy. I just love everybody. All my children, grandchildren, all of them here. It's all of them here. This is a blessing. This is a blessing. I won't ever forget this. And all of y'all be sweet. And I love you.
happy birthday.
Y'all stop running down the stairs.
Can you reach that?
You hear me? Or y'all fall. Y'all don't play on the stairs.